5 most advanced army robots at this moment. The United States military has a long record of being at the forefront of humankind's technological achievements. For example, it was the US Navy in the 1940s, led by Admiral Rickover, who pioneered the use of nuclear power as a propulsion device, and that eventually led to nuclear power plants for civilian use. Today, the military again leads the change into the future with their innovations in robotics and their many applications across the entire infrastructure of the organization. According to the National Defense Magazine, robotics funding for the military increased from $17 million in 2015 to $379 million in 2021. That number is only increasing as robots play an ever more important role across the entire field of military operations. Of course, more robots always means a greater need for people to work with these robots, and the military continues to be a source of robotics training for soldiers who can take their education to be on a fulfilling career in manufacturing after discharge. While the primary role of robots in the military continues to be supporting and behind the scenes, building, sanding, and maintaining equipment and machinery, there are some really exciting developments being made with robots that have more active roles. Therefore, don't forget to watch today's video to the very end for the 5 most advanced army robots at this moment. But before we begin, we request you to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to never miss another upload of ours. Having said that, let's jump right in. Number 5. MAARS. Powerful, modular, and combat-ready, the DCSN-1242 Gray Muzzle Module Activated Advanced Arms Robotic System, MAARS, is an unmanned ground vehicle designed specifically for reconnaissance, surveillance, and target acquisition missions to increase the security of personnel manning forward locations. MAARS can be positioned in remote areas where personnel are currently unable to monitor their security, and can also carry either direct or indirect fire weapon system. Agile and combat ready, MAARS keeps warfighters at a safe distance from enemy fire while effectively executing their security missions. MAARS enables the remote emplacement of RSTA sensors into critical locations up to several kilometers away, providing early warning while enabling immediate response if required. MAARS can be positioned in remote areas where personnel are currently unable to monitor the security, and can also carry either a direct or indirect fire weapon system. Remotely controlled by an operator equipped with a lightweight, wearable control unit, MAARS features multiple onboard day and night cameras, motion detectors, an acoustic microphone, a hostile fire detection system, and a loudspeaker system with a siren to provide optimum situational awareness and alarm. MAARS can even provide multiple options for the escalation of force when required by the rules of engagement, from non-lethal lasers, dazzlers, and audio deterrents, to less than lethal grenades, to lethal fires from the grenade launcher or the medium machine gun. MAARS is also extremely safe and tamper-proof, as it can be only operated when receiving properly coded instructions from its operator. Rugged and robust, MAARS offers unmatched modularity combined with the unique ability to remotely position advanced sensors and force application tools to greatly enhance the security of forward bases and outposts. Number 4. The Robobee. Insect-inspired robots with potential uses in crop pollination, search and rescue missions, surveillance, as well as high-resolution weather, climate, and environmental monitoring. Inspired by the biology of a bee, researchers at the Weiss Institute are developing Robobees, man-made systems that can perform myriad roles in agriculture or disaster relief. A Robobee measures about half the size of a paperclip, weighs less than 1/10 of a gram, and flies using artificial muscles, comprised of materials that contract when a voltage is applied. Additional modifications allow some models of Robobee to transition from swimming underwater to flying, as well as perch on surfaces using static electricity. The masterminding of the Robobee was motivated by the idea to develop autonomous and micro-area vehicles capable of self-contained, self-directed flight and of achieving coordinated behavior in large groups. To that end, the Robobee development is broadly divided into 3 main components: the body, brain, and colony. Body development consists of constructing robotic insects able to fly on their own with the help of a compact and seamlessly integrated power source. Brain development is concerned with smart sensors and control electronics that mimic the eyes and antenna of a bee, and can sense and respond dynamically to the environment. The colony's focus is about coordinating the behavior of many independent robots so they act as an effective unit. To construct Robobees, researchers at the Weiss Institute have developed innovative manufacturing methods, so-called pop-up microelectrical mechanical MEMS technology. Please also see the pop-up MEMS technology page that have already greatly expanded the boundaries of current robotics design and engineering. All areas for the use of Robobees are available for licensing. Number 3. The DOGO. Man-portable, miniature robots have been used in military missions for several years, but due to their size, limited payload capacity, and complex controls, their uses were restricted primarily to counter-improvised explosive devices, CIED, and reconnaissance. A new robot developed by Israel's General Robotics is introducing a new breed of combat robots at Eurosatory 2016, designed to assist combat teams in urban assaults and counter-terror operations. At a mission gross rate of only 12 kilograms, 26.5 pounds, the tactical tracked robot dubbed DOGO packs enough battery power to last for 2 to 5 hour mission, 8 cameras covering 360 degrees, and a fully loaded Glock 27 pistol and accessories mounted on Picatinny rails. The equipment carried on the rails provides various non-lethal effects, such as pepper spray, module, or a dazzler that temporarily blinds an aggressor from a distance of 5 to 10 meters. According to Shasal Gal, VP Business Development at General Robotics, DOGO was designed for special forces, SWAT teams, and infantry missions. The small, lightweight robot can climb stairs and move across difficult terrain. The robot has certain advantages over the human warfighter. Since the stable platform is more accurate than a human, and when operated from a safe distance, enables more time for situational assessment rather than the warfighter's instinctive response. While the robot is limited in its pursuit, using 2 DOGO in mutual cover would keep the target covered even in pursuit, trying to escape or engaging one of the robots. The small, stealthy robot is designed to be effective against targets much higher than itself. DOGO can aim its weapon very low, at the targets lying on the floor or hiding under a bed, or aim to hit a standing person at close range. The robot has an integral locked case designed for the 9mm Glock 26. The fully loaded weapon has 14 cartridges and is quickly attached to the DOGO, with remotely controlled safe arm mechanism. The DOGO robot is controlled by the Ranger Remote Control Unit, RCU, developed by General Robotics. The RCU uses a commercial, off-the-shelf, COTS, ruggedized FC-G1 Panasonic tough pad, encased with jacket providing the robotic controls. The RCU provides joystick controls to navigate the robot with point-and-shoot interface that allows the operator to design the weapon towards a target by touching the target as it appears on the screen. Operators that master the system after short training have demonstrated the ability to bring the weapon in 5 fire rounds in 2 seconds. Number 2. SAFFiR. The US Navy have unveiled a prototype of its shipboard autonomous firefighting robot, SAFFiR. The last time we saw SAFFiR, it wasn't much more than an aluminum core and 2 legs, but now it looks more like the futuristic firefighting humanoid it originally promised to be. We set out to build and demonstrate a humanoid capable of mobility aboard a ship, manipulating doors and fire hoses, and equipped with sensors to see and navigate through smoke, Office of Naval Research Program Manager Tom McKenna said at the Naval Future Force Science and Technology Expo. The long-term goal is to keep sailors from the danger of direct exposure to fire. SAFFiR, which was developed by researchers at Virginia Tech, stands 5 foot 10 inches tall and weighs 143 pounds. Infrared stereo vision sensors and a rotating laser allow the robot to see through dense smoke. Unlike DARPA's Atlas robot, SAFFiR can't stand without a tether, but it's capable of taking measured steps and handling a fire hose. For now, those movements come at the instruction of human controllers. During a test trial in November, SAFFiR worked in conjunction with a small drone, and Gadget reports. The quadcopter DC-21 uses infrared sensors and cameras to detect fires and maps of the topography of an area, which it can then communicate to the robot. The Navy is working on creating more advanced sensors for SAFFiR, as well as improving its speed, intelligence, and communication abilities. The drone's creators also plan on improving the battery life of DC-21, which currently tops out at 5 minutes. The ultimate goal is for SAFFiR to work in tandem with Navy officers, not replace them. We're working towards human-robot teams, McKenna said. It's what we call the hybrid force, humans and robots working together. Number 1. Gladiator. Designed to assist the US Marine Corps in various operations, the Gladiator tactical unmanned ground vehicle looks like a small tank, and can be outfitted with various modular tools and armaments depending on what the situation calls for. Although it tops out at 10 miles per hour, the Gladiator trades speed for toughness. It has an armored hull, and users can mount machine guns and grenade launchers directly onto its body. In 2002-2004, the OSD Joint Robotics Program and the Office of Naval Research funded an RTD&E program to develop technologies that dramatically increase the performance, capabilities, and affordability of the Gladiator. A team led by Carnegie Mellon University developed a prototype Gladiator system that was successfully demonstrated in February and July 2004. The focus of those demonstrations was on robotic mobility and robotic scouting, respectively. Following successful conclusion of the ONR program, the Robotics Systems Joint Project Office in Huntsville, Alabama, conducted a competitive procurement for the System Development and Demonstration Program. The program includes finalizing the Gladiator design, building 6 prototype vehicles, and delivering these vehicles with an appropriate support package to the Marines for operational evaluation in 2006. On February 7, 2005, RSJPO awarded a $26.4 million SDD contract to Carnegie Mellon University. In partnership with its primary subcontractor, BAE Systems, the Carnegie Mellon team is in the process of designing and developing a Gladiator system that will adhere to the Marine Corps' requirements. With that, we end today's video. If you enjoyed our content, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Lastly, join in next time for more of such interesting videos.